So thanks very much, everyone. Really good meeting with President Trump just there. An opportunity to talk about Irish-US relations, economic, political and cultural, which are, of course, very strong. Talked about Brexit. Needless to say, we have very different views on Brexit as to whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but was a real opportunity for me to set out Ireland's position, particularly when it comes to protecting the peace process and the Good Friday Agreement and avoiding a hard border. Talked about immigration too, very strong support from the President around the issue of securing more visas for Irish people to come and work here in the United States and to help solve the issue of tens of thousands of Irish people who came here a long time ago but are undocumented. Had a chance as well to thank him for his support on Achanish and helping to ensure that the Russian sanctions didn't result in hundreds of jobs being lost in Ireland's Midwest. And also a good opportunity to talk about a few other matters. So the US-Ireland relationship is very strong, and if anything, goes from strength to strength. The European Union, and Ireland is part of the European Union, as you know, and the US should come together and agree a trade deal. He feels that Europe treats America unfairly, but I believe the opportunity is there to do a trade deal between the EU and the US. Europe has done a great trade deal with Japan. We've done a great trade deal with Canada. If we bang our heads together, we can do a great trade deal in America too, which is the benefit of everyone. Whereas for the United Kingdom, it's going to be much harder. They won't be in a position to make trade deals for many years. Well, I suppose it's not particularly support that I've asked for from the President on Brexit. I know he's a supporter of Brexit, and I'm not. What I've asked for is an understanding of our situation, particularly when it comes to Northern Ireland and avoiding a hard border and protecting the peace process, and he is supportive on that point. Yeah, well, look, I respect their opinion. I was brought up Catholic myself, but we put this question to the Irish people in a referendum, and 64% of Irish people voted for choice and voted to liberalise our abortion laws, and we are a democracy. That's the decision that we have made. But what we all agree on is that we want to reduce the number of crisis pregnancies to prevent abortions ever happening in the first place. And we're putting a lot of investment into sex education, into making contraception more available so that women never face a crisis pregnancy in the first place. And that's something we all agree on. I think being Catholic has only ever been part of our identity. You know, we're a country that has a deep heritage. It's not just Catholic, it's Protestant as well. And indeed goes back to the pre-Christian era. So I think we're rebalancing to a country that sees itself as having a Christian heritage but not being exclusively defined by it.